Good morning, one and all. Dear students, last class we can be discussing about the electric generator, is it? So now you can be electric generator and also electric motor. We can be discussing how should be the magnetic effect of electric current should be using the, you know, how should be the current should be passed around that, how should be varied, and also what is the meaning of electromagnetic induction. All this can be discussed. In these sessions, we can be discussing about the what is the meaning of electric generator, how should be the working of generator, the principle of electric generator, all this you can be discussed. And also in your home, how can be the domestic electric circuit should be done, what is the meaning of electric fuse, what are the advantages of electric fuse. So like that you can be able to these sessions. So first one is electric generator. So you know that electric generator means, so it should be like a electric motor. How should be the electric motor should be work? Like that also electric generator should be, you can be seen. So this is based on the principle of electromagnetic inductions. So electric generator should be worked on which principle? It should be principle worked on the principle of what? Electromagnetic inductions. So like that you can be taken on the same galvanometer and also connecting wires. So these are the north and south pole. So again it can be used to the rectangular box, you can be taken, is it? So constructions you can be seen here. So like that north and south pole magnets you can be seen here. So this is the rectangular, it is to be called again. So this is, we can be called as the carbon brush 1 and also carbon brush V2. This is the galvanometer. This R1 and R2 we can be seen in the rings. So the electric generator consists of the rotating rectangular coil ABCD placed between the two poles of permanent magnet. So this is the rotating coil which can be the slowly rotated, that can be placed between the two poles, north pole and also south pole of the permanent magnet. The ends of these coils are connected to the two rings. Which are the two rings? R1 is also one ring, R2 is the another ring. So this is the R1 ring and also this is the, you can call as the R2 rings. So whatever these rings are there, these inside the rings are insulated. They will be insulated the copper wire. The two conducting stationary brushes. So this is the, you can call as the brushes. So this is the B1 brush, B2 brushes. So this one side and also this one side. This is the B1, this is the B2. So you can call as the carbon brushes. Are kept pressed separately the rings R1 and R2 respectively. So they can be connected with the each other brushes with the rings. So next one is the two rings which are R1. So this R1 rings and also this is the R2 rings. So these are internally attached to the axle. So whatever you can be called this one axle, no? So this axle they will be attached to the internally. R1 and also R2 rings are attached to the internally. The axle may be mechanically rotated. So when you should be started the rotations. So when you should be started the rotation. So AB should, arm should become upper side, CD should become to the lower side. Whatever these rings are there, they can be also rotated, they will be started to the rotated, the galvanometer should be past the ring. Outer ends of the two brushes are connected to the galvanometer to show the flow of current in the given Schumann circuit. So outer end of the two brushes means these two brushes. So B1 and B2 brushes are connected to the galvanometer. This should be shows to the passing of electric current. So whatever the axle attached to the two rings, that is you can be called as the R1 rings and also this is you can be called as the R2 rings. So which can be, they will be rotated in the arm, AB moves up in the magnetic field produced by the permanent magnet. So the arm AB should be from upper side. So they will produce the what? Permanent magnet. If the coil ABCD is rotated in clockwise direction. Clockwise direction is this direction. So that is you can be called as the clockwise directions. By applying the Fleming right hand rule, the induced current are set up in the arms along the relation of AB and CD. So the right hand rule, which can be thumb finger indicate the force, like the forefinger finger indicates the magnetic field and also middle finger indicates the magnetic flow of electric current, is it? So like that it should be passed on to that one. Thus an
induced current flows in the direction of ABCD. There is a large number of turns in the coil. The current generated in the east and add up to the large current flow of coil. So when it should be rotated started. So when the these rectangular ABCD coil should be rotated in the start when. So how many, the total number of the coils which can be depend upon the strength of the magnetic field. So this means that the current in the external circuit flow B2 to B1. So the current should be passing up to what? B2 to B1, they can be passed. After the off rotation, arm CD start moving up and also AB should be moving down. So in every rotation like that, AB should be one, off rotation should be completed and CD should be the another off rotation should be completed. When these two arms AB and CD they will be completed to that one, so they will be connected to each other. As a result, the direction of the induced current in the both arms changes, give rise to net induced current in the direction of DCBD. So once ABCD rectangular current should be passing completed, so the remaining diagram both arms change, the giving rise to the net induced current in the direction of DCBA. So this is the, you can record as a DCBA, all of the reverse direction you can be seen to that one. The current in the external circuit now flow from the B1 to B1. Again, when the direction should be changes B, B, C, B, A, again there will be changes to what? The current should be passed on the B1 to B2. Thus, after every off rotation, the polarity of the current in the respective arms changes. So, every off rotation, so see here, so this is the, you can write as A, B, C, D. So, when ABCD is the one off rotation, another one is, you can record as the DCBA as the another off rotation. So every off rotation, they can change the direction after equal intervals of time. This is called the alternating current. So this you can record as the alternating current, means every off rotation they will be changing the flow of direction of the current. That is, you can record as the alternating current, which is abbreviated, it can be short form, you can write on the AC. This device is also called as a AC generator. So this is also called as a what? AC generator. So here means the flow of current, the direction should be changes in the everyday off rotations. That's why it can be called as the AC current. To achieve the generator whose current does not change the direction with the time split ring type of the commutator must be used. So you can be used to the what? Split ring type of the commutator must be usable, not change. So in case it does not change the direction, so we can be used to what? Split ring type of the commutator we can be used here. With this arrangement, one brush is at all times the contact with the arm moving up in the field. So we can be used in the here brushes, is it? These B1 and B2 brushes we can be used like a commutator purpose. They can be, while other is connected with the arm moving down, which undergoes the progression of unidirectional current. So when they can be come to upper side, then what happens that the current should be moving the unidirectional. This generator is called as the direct current, or it can be called as the DC current. AC current means they can be change in the direction of every rotation, but in the DC current, so there will be current should be flow in the only single direction, that is, it can be called as the direct current. So what are the difference between AC generator and also DC generator? So see here, the difference between the direct current and also alternating current is that the direct current always flow in the one direction, where alternating current is flowing in the one, so there will be periodically changes. So see here. So this is the direct current. So there will be no changes. So here you can be used to this, you can be called as a commutator. So this is the load you can be seen. So there is always showing the only one direction, ABCD, or it should be moved to the DCBA. But in case of alternating current, whatever, we can be used to the split rings here. So split rings should be arranged in the parallel positions. So that is the every change, there will be change in the direction. Once again, they will be moved to the ABCD, another one is the DCBA. So the direction of current should be also changes. They will move like this. AB, then come to the CD. Here also they will move to the DC, then it should be come to the BA. So this is the difference between AC current and also DC current. DC current means direct current, you can define as the DC current. AC current means alternative current. Whatever it can be used in the poles, that is, it can be defined as the alternative current, it can be used to that one. Most of power stations constructed these days produce alternative current. So whatever it can be used in the production of the electricity by coal, heating, production of the heat in the coal, or it can be used in the dams. So that should be whatever produces the electricity, that is the form of the what? Alternative current. Whether it can be used in the dams or it can be used to the wind means that should be the turbines to the, it can be used to the grid, that should be current should be passed on the main electricity to homes, but all it can be depend upon the this AC current. In India, the AC changes duration after every 1/100 second. It means the frequency should be the 50 hertz, it can be seen. So every 1/100 second, so they will change the duration. Hence, the standard 50 hertz can be seen in the current. An important advantage of the AC over DC means, so we can be electric power supply, whatever power, electric power supply is there, that can be transmitted through a long distances without much loss of energy. So we can be send the current long distances without much loss of energy. So that is the, you can be seen the one of the advantages of the AC over DC. So first question, on which principle does the electric generator is work? An electric energy is converted into mechanical energy. Electrical energy is converted into thermal energy. Mechanical energy is converted into electrical energy. Lastly, electrical energy is converted into light energy. So which principle? They will convert it into mechanical energy into converted into electrical energy. So how should be the domestic electric circuit we can be done in the in our homes? So in our homes we receive the supply of the electric power through a main supply. Is it? So this is the picture, whatever this is, this is we can be called as the main picture line. So main supply, which can be called the mains, either supported through a overhead electric poles or by underground cables. Whether it should be the overhead. So overhead electric poles or can be used in the underground earth cables, also we can be supplied the current through our homes. So there are three kinds of wires in the cable. Include, we can be seen in any wires, there are three types of the wire. One is, you can be called as the live wire. So which current should be passed on the red color, that is the live wire. So green color you can be called as the earthing wire. So this color you can be called as the black color, that is, you can be called as the neutral wire. So if you see the meter board in the house, this wire passes the electricity meter to a fuse. So after this meter will be connected to the this fuse. So after this fuse it can be used to the our electric appliances. Through the main switch, they are connected to the light wires in the houses. So after the meter, they can be come to the fuse. Fuse to, we can be connected the various electrical switches. That electric switches we can be used to the various electric appliances. These wires are supplied to the electricity to separate circuit to the house. So maybe it can be used to the some typewriters, computers, or it can be used to the by electric bulb. So that can be used to the different purposes. It can be used to the different circuit, electric circuit can be seen to homes. These are two separate circuits that can be used generally. So one is 15 amperes current rating appliances, such as it can be called as the geyser, air coolers, etc. So maybe whatever it can be used to current rating appliances. So this is, we can be called as the geysers and also air coolers. They are to the high voltage current, that is, we can be used to the 15 amperes current. So like the 5 amperes current rating means it can be used with the electric bulb, fans, etc. That is, you can be used to the 5 ampere current. The earth wire, which is also insulating the green color. So in the, during wiring, it means the green color wire, which is, you can be called as the earthing wire, it is usually connected to the metal plate being insulated.
near the holes. So whatever meter board is there, that meter board under that one, so we have to the deep in the earth near the holes. So they can be connected to the metal plate deep in the earth in the holes. This is used as a safety measures, especially for those appliances that have a metallic body. For example, electric press, used to the electric press, toaster, table fan, refrigerator. So that can be avoided that one. So whether these metallic electric appliances can be used to that one, they be prevent the any damages you can be used to that one. Thus, it ensures that the any leakage of the current in the metallic body of the appliances gives the potential to the depth of earth and user may not get a severe electric shock. So it can be used in the rubber soled shoes, or so it can be used in the dry hands. So in case of any leakages in the current, it can be prevent to that one using the earthing wire. The common domestic electrics are represented by the schematically. So this is the, it can be called as the live wire. One is live wire, another one is the neutral wire. This is the, it can be used in the main fuse. The main fuse should be the power to the electric meter, we can be seen. So that is the main switches. That main switches can be connected to the various appliances in the parallel directions. Lastly, all these appliances should be connected to the earthing wire. Earth wire should be connected to the earth connections. The common domestic circuit represented by the each separate circuit, different appliances can be connected across the live and neutral wire. Whatever you can be used in the appliances, that should be connected to the two wires, that is live wire and another one is the neutral wire. Each appliances should be switch on and off options we have. In order to let each appliance is equal to the potential difference, they are connected to the parallel to each other. So in case of it can be connected in the series, any one appliance should be damaged, all the appliances should be does not go in the electric current. To overcome this problem, it can be used to the parallel connected wires. So mainly electric fuse we can be used to the all the domestic circuit. A fuse is a circuit prevent the damage of appliances from the circuit due to overloading. So where we can be used to the fuse means, because any excess current should be come on to that one. So that should be the damaged appliances. So that should be the, in case of any overloading to the single socket, we can be used to the many plus that time we can be, that electric fuse should be the prevent the damage of electric appliances. Overloading can be occur when the live wire and the neutral wire come in direct contact. Suppose both two wires should be connected to the coming across to the direct current. In such a situation, the current in the circuit abruptly increases. This is called short circuit. Maybe sometimes wire should be damaged or loosening. So then also the current should be flow overloading. So that is can be called as the short circuit. Thus, the use of electric fuse prevents the electric circuit and appliances of the possible damage by stopping the flow of unduly high electric current. So whatever limit of electric current, that limit should be overloaded, they can be prevented to that one. The job heating that take place in the fuse melt in the break the electric circuit. The fuse should be melt, they can be the stop the flow of electric circuit. Yes, you can be used to the, this is the safety purpose, you can be used to that one. Overloading can be also occur due to an accidental leakage in the supply of voltage. So maybe we can be single socket, it can be used for the various appliances. So see the picture here, they can be used for the iron box, so they can be used to the refrigerator, table fan, and also computer. So here also fans. Only single socket, it cannot be used to the all the plugs in the at a time, then it should be. Then it should be what happened, it should be overloading. Sometimes overloading is caused by connected to too many appliances to the single circuit. That is also you can be seen in the current should be leakage. So first question, which color insulation cover is used for the earthing wires? So that is the green color. Is it red, black, green? Can be any color. So that is the green color. Is it?
So next second question. During the situation of the short circuit, the current in the circuit reduced to zero, increased greatly, does not change, oscillate. It should be reduced to zero. Increases greatly. During the situation of the short circuit, what happens? The current in the circuit should be increases greatly. So next one is brief explanation or brief summary of these lessons. So you know that a compass needle is a small magnet. It can be one end which can be point towards the north pole, another which points towards the south is called as the south pole. A magnetic field exists in the region surrounding a magnet in which the force of the magnet can be detected. Field lines are used to represent the magnetic field. Either it should be north to south, or they are hypothetically free from north pole to would be moved to move. The direction of the magnetic field lines point given by the direction of the north pole placed at the point of would take. Field lines are shown closer together where the magnetic field is stronger. So when the magnetic field are very close together, so that is the magnetic field that is also greater. A metallic wire carrying an electric current is associated with a magnetic field. Field lines about the wire consists of the series concentric circle rules. The rest is also given by the right hand rules. The whatever the concentric circle that should be represented by the electromagnetic field. The pattern of the magnetic field around a conductor due to electric current flowing through it depends upon the shape of the conductor. So this is a brief summary of this lesson. So today's class it will be discussed about the electric generator. How should be the domestic electric circuit we can be seen? How should the, what is the, how can be the wiring? What is the meaning of AC current and also DC current? So this, thank you and all.